fidelity meta-analysis is an individual patient data meta-analysis combining data from two trials. The FIDELIO-DKD trial, where patients with chronic kidney disease and diabetes have been randomized to finerenone and placebo, and FIGARO-DKD trial, where a similar patient population, but with less severe chronic kidney disease, randomized also to finerenone and placebo. In FIDELIO-DKD, finerenone in patients with predominantly stage 3-4 CKD, a population with high kidney risk, improve kidney and cardiovascular outcomes. And in FIGARO-DKD, in a broad population of patients with stages 1 to 4 chronic kidney disease and diabetes, finerenone improved cardiovascular outcomes. In FIDELITY, we evaluated in 13,000 patients for a more robust understanding of the efficacy and safety of the drug in a broad range of the disease than either trials alone. Patients randomized 1:1 to receive finerenone or placebo, and the finerenone or placebo were on the top of optimal medical therapy, including maximum tolerated dose of renin-angiotensin system blocking therapy. What we've seen is that finerenone reduced the risk of experiencing the composite cardiovascular outcome by 14% compared to placebo, and the risk of experiencing a kidney outcome event by 23%. And overall safety outcomes were generally similar between finerenone and placebo, and the higher rate of hyperkalemia from finerenone in the study was 14% for finerenone versus 6.9% for placebo. But few patients had to permanently discontinue treatment because hyperkalemia, 1.7% versus 0.6%. I think that this is important for everyday clinical practice, and I think this is something that also in cardiology we should consider, because 40% of the population of the patient had chronic kidney disease with an estimated GFR above 60%. And the chronic kidney disease was evident from the albuminuria. We see many patients in everyday clinical practice in cardiology, history of cardiovascular disease, GFR above 60. We never consider to check for albuminuria. Now we have an effective therapy, and we know that in these patients with preserved GFR and albuminuria, if we check for this, we can have an effective therapy. I think this is the important message for everyday clinical practice from this pooled analysis.